And now let's actually practice some of the things we've learned in this course. This video is your practice exercise. This is what the trial balance looks like before the 10 transactions that you are about to enter. This is what your profit and loss looks like before the 10 transactions that you are about to enter. Here are the transactions that you should read from this video and record into QuickBooks. You can pause the video at this moment and put the video in one window, position the QuickBooks software in the other window, and read from this window and record everything you see. There are only 10 transactions. By recording what you see, you will be practicing what you learned in the previous videos. Record them exactly as you learned in the previous lessons. If you forgot something, go back to the video of the transaction that you forgot and watch it again. Then come back to this video and finish recording the transactions. When you finish, compare your results to the results I am now about to show you. This is what your trial balance should look like after you finish entering the 10 transactions. You may pause the video at this moment to compare it to your trial balance. If it looks different, you have to use the techniques that we learned about in the video to find and fix your mistakes. That is also true about the profit and loss. This is what your profit and loss should look like after recording the 10 transactions from this video. And again, if it's different, you have to use the skills you learned to find and fix your mistakes. To help make it easy, I'm going to show you what the results will look like in each of the 5 registers that you were recording the transactions into. This is what your Chase Bank register should look like after the exercise set. This is what your M&T Bank register should look like after the exercise set. This is what your Capital One register should look like after the exercise set. And you can pause the video and go through it carefully. This is what your City Card register should look like after the transaction set. And last but not least, this is what the register should look like that will show you how the cash came in and out of your wallet. Again, if there's any difference, you can go back and change anything that's different to make it the same as what I have. Then your reports will be the same.